What's going on, guys and girls? My name is James, or thanks to and welcome back to another episode of Pixelmon here on the fantastic Pixel Core server. Very, very exciting. We have just had a prompt which has said a legendary has spawned in a jungle biome. So I was in the house here just doing some stuff, and we got the prompt. Super, super excited. I think I may know what this is, so if we can find it, this could potentially be awesome. What a great way to start the episode. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we're going to find this. I'm thinking this is the only jungle that's any close, so I'm gonna take a look in here first. Yeah, this wasn't the plan for this. Oh my god, you see it? Yes! Yes! Wild Mew! Oh my god, Wild Mew. Let's catch it! Yes! Oh my god, I've been wanting to catch this for so long. So we have a Wild Mew. Now, the question is, should we or should we not use our Master Ball on it? Because we do have it, and apparently it's very difficult to catch. But yeah, let's see what we can do here. Let's see if we can weaken it up a little bit here with Prinplop. This is going to die straight away pretty much, but let's get Jeremy out. Jeremy would be the perfect level for this, but I've got some very powerful moves here, and I'm just kind of worried about killing it. So, Oh dear. God. I don't know what to do. I really don't want to kill this. I've waited like 28 episodes to catch one of these. These moves are all so powerful. What else have I got here? Have I got any moves that are just like kind of alright? This, bearing in mind this guy, okay, I can take down. Don't kill it. Oh yeah, this is good. Okay, just don't hit a critical. Alright, okay. Okay. I'm gonna have a go from here. Fastball, go! Come on, Mew. We can do this. Oh man, this thing is so rare. Oh god, straight away it's broken out. Let's see what else we've got. We've got quite a lot of different balls. Let's try a luxury ball. Let's see if we can get it. Oh my god, have we got a Mew? This means we can actually get a cloning machine, and we can actually make a Mewtwo, which would be absolutely awesome. So, what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to chuck some Pokeballs at it. And then hopefully, if we do catch it with that, great. Because I was kind of... Oh, God. Yeah, okay. We could, though. We've got a Legendary. So, to be honest, like, we can cycle through these Pokemon. They could take some hits, whatever. Heavy Ball? Why not? Let's try it. Let's give it a go. I did catch the other Legendary with a Heavy Ball. Although, having said that, this isn't exactly a very heavy Pokemon. So, that was probably a stupid thing to do. I do have my Master Ball, though. So, Fastball. Oh god, I'm so excited. What an amazing way to start it. You know, the weird thing is, it's literally about 10 minutes before this shout, we had a shout for a legendary spawning in an ocean biome. Now, I know what the legendary one is. It's the Kyogre again. We already have two of those, so I was kind of like, nah, we'll leave it. Came back to the house, and then straight away, boom, this actually happened. Oh god, this is hard to catch. This has got a super, super low. Let's try some timer balls. See if we can get it. Come on, Jeremy, we can do this. We can catch Mew. That's exciting. Oh god, we're doing well. Come on. Oh, I think that was like, what, two shakes maybe? Let's chuck another timer ball at it. Come on. That's one shake. That's probably two shakes. Oh, three shakes. Come on. Ah, it's broken out. Oh, okay. See, now, the one thing I don't know is actually, hopefully, if we're going to catch this, if it all fails, I will chuck the Master Ball at it, because we could probably maybe get another one of those just by, you know, luck on bosses, basically, so it's not too bad. These guys are supposed to be very, very tricky to catch. But yeah, I want to try and look into the cloning machine, because obviously Mew is great, but Mewtwo, that is insane. So that could be a very, very cool thing to have. Fortunately, it's not healing itself, so I do have a Gengar, which I could maybe try and... I've got Brian the Gengar, so we could put it asleep, maybe. That might help. Come on. We can do this. Come on, two shakes. Yes! Yes! Oh, yeah, I'm so happy. Yes, that's amazing. So, we have caught our second unique legendary of a Mew. Oh, I'm so happy. Yes! I don't know if you could tell. Oh, that's amazing. Okay, let's go check this guy out straight away. Where's my house? There's my house. I've lost all direction. I'm panicking. All right, let's go and check this out. So this is awesome. This is our second legendary that we've caught now. So we've got the Kyogre. We've got two Kyogres, technically. But we've got Kyogre, and now we've got Mew. So we are missing quite a few other legendaries. I'd love to catch them all. That would be insane. But it is pretty much just luck of the draw. As, you know, I'm on the server, and if something spawns, then great. But I do think this is one of the harder ones. So I'm pretty good positioned here, right next to the jungle biome. So that certainly does help, I reckon. All right, let's go in here. Let's get it out. What can we say goodbye to? Anything level 60 yet? Oh, they're all so close. I've got an idea, actually. Let's, just before we take a look at it, let's get some summaries of these guys. Yeah, so if we level up Brian one more level, then he will effectively be ready to box. So we can directly swap him in for Mew. Yes! It's amazing. Let's kill this Arbok. Right, let's kill him off with a Shadow Ball. Boom. Ah, this is... Brian is such an amazing Pokemon. Ah, level 60. GG, Brian. You're officially retired for now from the party. Let's close this hatch. There we go. Oh, this is amazing. So my plan today was actually to try and find some Eevees, so we can maybe look at some evolutions. I think there's like 7 different Eevees we can get, which is pretty cool. But that might have to sort of get on the old back burner here for a second, because potentially we could have some cool times ahead. So let's get rid of Gengar. Thank you, Gengar. You have been awesome. But we have Mew now. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Boom! Yes! How cool is that? I love the way it hovers. It's amazing. Check this out. Hang on, let me get rid of the interface. Yeah! How awesome is that? That is so cool. Oh, hail the mighty Derpichu. Right, so let's get this guy healed up. And then we're going to take a look at the stats and see what we've got here. So let's go and heal these guys up. But yeah, how is everyone doing? Are you good? Yes? Excellent. Really, really happy with that. We also do still have our Master Ball, which is good news. Because I kind of wanted to. This may sound kind of stupid and a bit of a waste, but these up here are kind of like the original generation balls. So you've got the Pokeball, the Great Ball, the Ultra Ball, and the Safari Ball. But I kind of wanted to have the Master Ball in there. So you've got like Pokeball, Great Ball, Ultra Ball, Master Ball in the 4 different stages. But yeah, I don't know yet. I mean, we could. Oh, God. Actually, no, hang on, let's check a look at the stats. Summary. Yes! Mew! So we've got Pound. Oh, Metronome is an amazing move. I love Metronome. That's such a cool move. Psychic and Barrier. Its stats are... Its growth is Giant, which is cool. Its nature is Quirky, whatever that means. Really nice attack and defense stats for something level 50. Yeah, let's go and do a battle with it. Let's go and get it into action. Snorlax, perfect. Ah, despawned. I heard a Diglett. Did you hear that? I heard that. Ooh, wheat. Ooh, just growing my wheat here for no reason. Alright. Let's see what we can find. What level is Golett? Level 42. Perfect. Boom! So we got a Mew in battle. Let's do some Metronomes for fun. Use Metronome. It had no effect. What? I thought Metronome picked a move. Oh, does it not do it in this one? Pound is... It's a normal move, isn't it? Metronome, in my knowledge... Oh, my God, that's so powerful. Metronome, in my knowledge, was... It picked, like, a random move. But does it work in Pixelmon? I genuinely have no idea whatsoever. So, wow, what an awesome way to start the episode. Oh, my God. Very, very, very cool. Let's head over here now. Let's check out the old... yes, one of my finer works. I'm quite pleased with that, actually. Oh, we haven't put anything in the slime. Let's fight this Lampent. Mew! Psychic! Go! Oh, I burnt, as if. Come on, let's kill it. So hopefully this should learn some pretty good moves. We do have quite a lot of TMs that we can teach it. I was kind of hoping that... I was thinking that Metronome would be more like it is in the actual games, but... Magical. Please feed the slime with donation... Oh, God. Have we got anything to give? Let's give some leather. Let's give... give him a metronome. I have like 17 metronomes. And let's give him 3 ender pearls. Blip! There we go. Feed the slime! Oh, I'm so excited. Ah! So, from what I can tell, we still have maybe... Well, there are 3 legendary birds, all of which are no longer available currently, anyway. So, we can't get those. But we do have a Groudon still to get. We have a Rayquaza still to get. And, we do have the Mewtwo from the cloning machine. Now, oh, it's a Cubone. Oh, these are really hard to find. Hang on, wait a minute. I'm going to catch one of these. These guys are really hard to find because, I've not seen one of these before, actually. Let's see if we can catch this guy. With my really awesome Mew. Yes. Oh, it's so cool. It's so cool. All right. Okay, well, wait a minute. No, I don't need to catch it. I more wanted to see what happens if I kill it, because it drops the thingamajigs, which are really hard to find. There we go. Bone. Boom. Yeah, because the bone is for the bone meal, and it's really hard to get bone meal. Like, you wouldn't believe how hard it is to get bone meal. And the bone meal I use for... I've only ever used it once, and it's for the... I had some grey wool in my house, so I had to use the bone meal to use the dye and stuff. So that's the only reason why I like to kill them. I was going to catch it, but I thought, nah, screw it. We've got a Mew! Everything is irrelevant this episode. We have a Mew, and it is awesome. So, I think maybe what we should look into is perhaps the process that goes behind cloning to try and get a Mewtwo. I think that would be awesome. I'd love to have a Mewtwo. So, I don't know, let's get the old crafting menu up here. Which button is it? That one. And let's see what the cloning machine actually is. I'm sure there is one somewhere around here, but I'd quite like to have one for myself. That's a trading monitor, fossil machine. Ah, cloning machine. So this is a cloning machine. So you're going to need a green tank, an orange tank, and a cloner cord. Cloner cord is obsidian and redstone. We are going to have to go and get more obsidian, I think. Because I don't think we have enough. Actually, there's loads of obsidian next to the volcano area where we caught the... What's it called? Oh, what did we catch there? We caught something there. So that's not too bad. We've got the redstone. The green tank is emeralds. Ooh. That's another challenge. So hopefully we might be able to find some NPC villagers, which might be able to... Do they ever trade emeralds? Or do they only want them in return? I can't quite remember. Emeralds are going to be a bit of an issue, actually, because... they're going to be very hard to get. Which is the problem. I don't think I've found any emeralds, actually, in this entire sort of day. This entire series, even, when I've been digging, I've not found a single emerald, so you need to get the right underground biome, and that is a little bit tricky at times. The question is, where are all of my NPC village buddies? Go away, Dribble. You're irrelevant against Mew! Yes! Oh, God! Oh, there we go, stick it back. You didn't see it. Alright, I think we should heal up. I don't suppose by any chance someone's left some emeralds in here? No, is the answer to that one. Damn. Anything good in there? No, it's just some stuff, isn't it? Alright, let's go and heal up Mew again. I really like the little icon in the corner for the picture of it. I don't really know if you can see it too well, but it looks really awesome. Hang on, I might be able to get it a bit bigger. Hang on a sec. Where is it? Summary. Ooh. There we go. That looks really cool, don't you think? I like it. Alright, so I don't know if we can find any villagers or anything. So hang on, wait, we didn't actually finish what we needed. So the orange tank is gold, fossil machine. Oh, has he got like a fossil machine as well? There's a lot of stuff, man. I'm sure we can do it, though. I'm sure we can do it. So I think that this episode is probably going to be dedicated to getting the resources together and slowly making what we need. So, there's an NPC villager here. Hello, sir. What's your trade? Yeah, emeralds for a thingamajig. Don't really need that trade. See, I have quite a few resources stocked up. As if I found a Mew! Yes! I'm still, like, really excited from that. That's cool. So close to the house as well. I like that. I like that a lot. So I think we should probably see what we can do in terms of making what we can. Do we need two fossil machines? Or is it cloning machine here? We do. We need to make two fossil machines. So we need tops and bottoms. That's going to be hammering a lot of aluminium plates out. So I could probably do that now, I guess. That won't take too long. But I'll probably do that off camera because it's a little bit dull. The fortunate thing is, though, we do actually have, I think, we found off a boss a... Yeah, we've got a couple of diamond hammers here, which should make things go really nice and quick. Where's our resources? Here? So we've got lots of aluminium there, which should hopefully be enough. Hopefully. Did we use all of our other aluminium? I think we did. So we got anything else we can deposit in here, actually? No, raspberries do not live in there. I'm going to put this bone in here because it's really rare. Well, it's not really rare, but it is, from my experiences, it is pretty hard to get. So, have we got anything else we can stick in there? I don't think so. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to hammer out all of this aluminium plate. In case you've never seen how you hammer out aluminium plates in Pixelmon, I'll just do one to show you. It's pretty tedious, but I kind of like it in a weird way. So I set up this little sort of anvil-y place over here for everyone to use. Get a free hammer in. So if we stick it down on the thing, it actually goes like that. And if we just hold down, oh God. Oops, hang on. There we go. And if we, there we go, hold down left click, it actually sort of flattens the ingot. It's actually really quick with a diamond hammer. And then boom, we have an aluminium plate. So yeah, I'm going to try and make loads of aluminium plates. And I will see you guys in a sec. Okay, so I've done my hammering. I have 21 plates. Fingers crossed that is going to be enough. I haven't double checked it just yet, but I do know it does take quite a few in order to get the machine going. The cloning machines, we're going to need two of those to make... No, not the cloning machines, the thinger machines. You know the ones I mean. Fossil machines, yeah. So we're going to need two fossil machines. We need that as well. So it's pretty much obsidian, redstone. Redstone! Don't know why I said that. Redstone and the other one, thingamajigs. But what we're going to do now is just very quickly, I'm going to have to get some obsidian. So I have my diamond pickaxe here. I know it's a little bit damaged, but it doesn't really matter too much. So we're going to stick an enchantment on that. Just to try and maybe get efficiency or something. Just something little. I know we're going to get 15 levels, but it'd probably be better than nothing. So fingers crossed on that one. Let's head down to the enchanting room. I didn't even get a chance to do this. Like, this was... Oh my God! What the hell are you doing here? Terrible idea. You know what, fine. You can live here. You can live here as well. Oh God, please be quiet. So we got a 13. How high are those? 15. Come on! Yes! Efficiency 2! Man, my enchanting is going well so far. So yeah, I'm going to show you where this obsidian is, and this is what I mean. I think we're going to need maybe like, I don't know, maybe like 10, 12 bits. Actually, let's double check. So we're going to need one, we're going to need two for that. Any of these need it? No. So that's just plates. But we're going to need three for that. We're going to need three for that. And we're going to need six for that. Okay, so six. Yeah, we need about 12 or so. I'll just grab as many as I can, really. I wonder if we could ride Mew. Is that possible? No. Unlucky. Unfortunate! Oh well. It's a bit small to ride, maybe. But we could ride it into battle. It would be so majestic. You would not even believe. Alright, let's head over. So yeah, this is kind of the area that I was thinking of having redstone in. I think that there should be some here. There's a load of lava. And if I remember correctly, there was obsidian, but I can't quite... Like, if there isn't any or if there isn't enough, I can just head over to one of the random mines, which are sort of around that area, and take a bucket of water or whatever. It's no big deal, but hopefully this will be a little bit quicker to grab the resources that we need. So I also actually need to read up about the cloning thing. So what I'll probably do is I'll probably craft the bits that are needed and then have a little read on Wikipedia. The Pixelmon Wikipedia, just to make sure I know what I'm doing, because I've never cloned before. One does not simply clone, because Mew is quite rare. As if I just call it Mew. Yes! Ha ha! Wait till the other guys hear about this. I'll be like, hey, you want to see my Mew? it's so cool. So whilst we're running around, just thought I'd let you know. In regards to the Thanksia server, I made like a little announcement thing a couple of episodes ago. Ooh, I hit my microphone. About the reason why the current one is closed and it won't be coming back up. But the good news is I've actually managed to... I've actually managed to negotiate a brand new server, which is really, really good. So we're actually going to be hosted via MC Pro Hosting. Mew's dead. MC Pro Hosting, which is the server who have loads and loads of really big names, which is why it's very, very exciting for me. Just some off the top of my head, Skyder's Minecraft has his servers through this company. Moonstone. Oh, Dream Eater. Nice. Skyder's Minecraft. Oh, Primplup. Hey. Let's evolve it. Primplup is evolving. Let's see what we get. And I think it's Empoleon. Is it Empoleon? I hope so. Grow! Get bigger! Yes! Oh my God, it's massive. How cool is that? Yeah! Check that out. So Whirlpool. No, I don't want to learn Whirlpool. Hey, that's awesome.
Empoleon!
Oh, it's massive! Yes, this was an excellent choice. Wow, check that out. You look like a beast. I like you. Okay, so yeah, anyway, it's with MC Pro hosting, so it's got like Skydiz Minecraft, Sunday, oh, SS Sunday, I don't really know how to say it, just two off the top of my head, loads and loads of really, really awesome YouTubers, so yeah, super excited about that. And also, just in case you are interested, because I know a lot of people like to have servers and stuff, but if you ever are looking for a Minecraft server, there's actually a link in the description of my videos, this one and any of them onwards. And if you click on that link for the MC Pro hosting server, then you actually get like a discount off because of the partnership that I've got. So I think that's pretty cool. So if you are looking for a server for you and your friends or whatever, then yeah. Take a look. It's pretty cool. All right, there's actually no obsidian here. I swear there was obsidian. What the hell? No!
Empoleon!
How is Mew still alive? Why is it... Stop it! Didn't Mew faint? I am so confused right now. When it faints, does it automatically get rejigged? Really? No. Surely. Maybe. That is very interesting, isn't it? Yes, Vulpix. Hmm. Okay, interesting. Right, okay, so what I'm actually going to have to do is I'm actually going to have to go off-piste, so to speak, to do a little bit of mining to get the obsidian that's needed. I think that's pretty much all we actually need. I think we have enough aluminium, so... yeah, we're going to do that, and yeah, I should meet you guys back in a second. Okay, so yeah, this is the situation. Basically, I've been doing a little bit of reading on the old cloning machine and all of that stuff, and as well as the resources that I need, I'm actually going to need an absolute ton of diamonds. So in order to get the best possible probability of finding myself or gaining myself a Mewtwo, for a 75% chance, what I need to get is 3 blocks of diamond, which is a lot of diamond, bearing in mind that we only have 4 diamonds at the moment. So I decided basically to come down here. I found myself a brand new cave system, so this one should be untouched. I literally found an idol and I dug down. Where did I dig down? I fell through the ceiling somewhere. Was it up there? I don't know. You can hear the water. Oh no, that's that water. I think I came through there. Anyway, so this is a brand new system. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to have a marathon digger sesh. Unfortunately, I don't have a fortune pick, which would make life so much easier. But I don't have one. I'm just hoping that there might be a fossil here, just because it might be pretty cool. But yeah, so I'm going to have this big old dig down here. I'm going to go down and do some mining down. Hopefully try and get as many diamonds as possible. Whilst I'm down here as well, I'm going to grab myself some obsidian. And yeah, just hopefully maybe even a couple of fossils if I can. And then hopefully I'll meet you guys back when I've kind of done that. So... yeah, it's gonna be a bit of a long one, to be honest with you. It's gonna take me some time to do this. It would be easier to do the old torch trick with these, wouldn't it? Oh, for God's sake, that was appalling. Bloop, bloop, bloop. What? Oh, I'm not fast enough on the fingers. Hang on. Oop. There we go. Oh, I'm so poor at this. Bloop. Wait a minute, I placed that. There we go. So yeah, I'm literally going to have a massive digger sesh, which might take some time. So I don't really think anyone's really that interested in seeing me dig on Pixelmon anyway. Like vanilla Minecraft, I think we can get away with that. But on something like Pixelmon, I don't think people want to see that. So hopefully what I'll do is if I find anything cool, maybe a fossil or something like that, I will let you know. Let's just finish this area off here for the sake of it. Yeah, I spent a lot of time digging for fossils. I think we only have 3 different unique ones. The cool thing is, though, we do have an Aerodactyl, which is pretty cool. But, yeah, so let's just see if we've got anything down here. I know this is the most inefficient way of doing it. I could be using the torch trick, but you know what? It's a diamond pick. It's a diamond shovel. It's pretty quick. So it's not too bad, really. There's nothing down here, is there? So much gravel down here, though. Like, you've got to be pretty lucky to find these fossils. Because they are pretty rare to find. Like, I've actually done quite well to find. I think we found 4 fossils so far, or something like that. So you've just got to look for, like, a randomly brown piece of something, and then, yay, you found one. But, no, as of yet, I haven't found one. Okay, so yeah, as I mentioned, I'm going to go for a big marathon digger sesh. Going to get much lower to try and find those diamonds. And I'm kind of unsure if we're going to find, like, a load of them, but I'll try and find as many as I can, and then I'll probably just continue with this for about an hour or so, maybe. But yeah, if anything cool happens, I'll let you guys know. But yeah, until we speak again. Okay, so yeah, a bit of an update really. I've essentially been branch mining around the diamond regions, so it's been going alright so far actually. We've got some, we've been finding stuff like this. So the first lot I actually found was a big, like a bunch of five, but I managed to basically lose two of them in the water, which I wasn't too happy about, to be honest with you, but it's going alright so far. So I'm kind of just double checking that there's not going to be any more shenanigans here. So we're just a quick little recap really as to what's going on. We've got ourselves 8 diamonds here at the moment, so that's pretty decent. We found ourselves some more diamonds here. I'm going to keep doing this. I haven't actually found any fossils, sadly. I did look, but unfortunately, as of yet, we haven't really found any fossils. Ah, I just lost my water source. Damn it, I really didn't want to do that. Ah, all right, so let's grab the ones we can here. No fortune pick is the killer right now. It is making everything take twice as long. Whoa! No, 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 I do not want to be burnt. Place that blocks, place that blocks, place that blocks, place that blocks. Come on, come on, gravel. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Actually, we shouldn't die. So, yeah, I'm going to have to go and find myself a new water source block type thing. So that's going to be fun. Yeah, I'm just going to keep doing this, basically. So I don't really think people want to see this, as I did mention. So I'm just going to keep going. And, yeah, fingers crossed, new water source. Come on. Just grab this here quickly. Where are you? Where are you? Yes. No. Oh, man. The problem is with some of these is that the water sources are super high up in the air, which is what I'm finding. So as you can see, that's right at the top there, which is making it a bit of a pain when I'm sort of creating it. I'm just a bit derpy with my fingers when it comes to sort of isolating. Ah, that's perfect. Nope. There we go. Right. So I'm going to continue doing this, and yeah, I'll meet you guys back in a sec. Okay, so yeah, welcome back. I finished my mining expedition right now, so yeah, I've been back for a little while here, just kind of getting some of the recipes prepared. I actually needed a bit more of the aluminium ore, so it's not too bad because we did pick up some as we were mining. So what I've made so far is I've actually made 2 of the fossil machine tag Pokemon items, which are for either one, both of the thingamajigger thingers, you know the ones I mean. And for God's sake, why do you have to come all the whole map to play and you do it outside my treehouse? What is going on there? So yeah, anyway, right. What was I doing here? We actually have 2 fossil machine bases. We have 1 fossil machine top, so we need to make another fossil machine top, which is what I actually ran out of aluminum for. So let's stick that there. Boom. So we've got 2 tops, 2 middles, 2 ends. So let's go 1, 2... 1, 2, and then 1, 2. Oh, God, there's torches. Come on, James, we can do better. All right, is that the other way around? What? 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 Oh, can I not do 2 in 1 go? This is confusing. Am I only supposed to do 1 at a time? Oh, I need to make this one as well. Okay, so that's obsidian and 4 redstone. That's not too bad. We did actually get quite a bit of each one. So we do have a decent amount of resources here. I did get like a few extra obsidian just in case, which I thought was a good idea. So let's try that again. This is the base. That is the middle. That one is the top. So 1, 2. There we go. So we have our 2 fossil machines now, which is kind of handy. Where are we looking? I did also make the clone accord already. So the only problem is now are these 2 shiny, shiny emeralds, which are the ones that we're going to struggle. So we can actually make the gold one. I have plenty of gold ore. I have the diamonds required as well for the thingamajig. What do I mean? The, what's it called? I've completely forgotten. What is it? Aluminium on the top? Please. Yes. Okay, so there we go. This is the orange tank. So that I do have the diamonds required for the cloning thing, so we can get the highest possible percentage chance, which is good. So we've got a fossil machine, our orange tank. The only thing that we are lacking, unfortunately, is the emeralds needed in order to make the other machine. So Yeah, leave that one with me. I think it's actually about time, unfortunately, to call it a day for this particular episode. But when we get back to next episode, which won't be too long, so stay tuned, we will hopefully have those emeralds available and we will actually be able to have a crack at evolving or cloning our Mew into a Mewtwo. So that sounds pretty awesome, right? It could fail and we could get a Ditto, but I do think we keep the Mew, so all is not lost. But yeah, okay, so I think that is going to be about it for today's episode. Thank you so much for watching, guys. As always, if you could please remember to leave a like, that would be awesome. Really, really helps out and helps support the channel and stuff. So if you could take a second to do that, I'd muchly appreciate it. And also, if you're not yet subscribed, go for it. We do Minecraft on fun. But until next time, thank you once again for watching. It's been such a pleasure. As always, thanks. Hail the mighty Derpichu. And see ya.